Hi everyone, welcome to Colouring with Kate and thank you for joining me today. So I thought I'd do a quick video just to show you what I took on holiday with me, just to the Lake District, and we only went for about 4 nights, and I'm just going to show you the colouring stuff I took with me, and yeah, we are going to go away to Wales later on for a week, so I'll probably take the same stuff except probably some different books. So Kitty says hi, and yeah, let's get started. So I hope you're all doing well as well, and thank you for your comments, and I really do enjoy reading them, and I hope you're enjoying your colouring as well. So the first thing I took with me was my 2022 Creative Companion. I just took this with me because it's something to write on and, you know, just helps me keep track of things. So I just took that with me as well. So that was the first thing. And then I took two, I mean, I have my own little suitcase I can take with me with these things in it. I do get to fit other things in there. But yeah, this is one of the pencil cases I took with me. So of course, I'll just quickly show you. And so in here I have the 24 ink tents and then a few additional open stock ink tents, I think, that I wanted to put in here as well, just some additional colors. I think there were some blues actually that I wanted, but I put them in color order. And then this is my 60 polychromes set, and I did add in a few extras like this. For example, was an open stock green gold. It's one of my favorite colored polychromos pencils, and so I included that in there. So I really do like the polychromos, and I wasn't going to take these originally, but then because of one of the books I decided to take, these work quite well in there, so I decided to take them. Then I've got some Prismacolors. So these are some open stock Prismacolors. I've taken some out here which I'm using. But yeah, some open stock Prismacolors, and I think it was maybe a 36 or 24 set with some additional colours, I can't remember, but I just picked some colours, additional ones in there. So yeah, have to take some Prismacolors because I really enjoy using them. The polychromos and some ink tents in that one. Right, what else? And then I took this gigantic case as well. So this is, I really like this case. I got it off Amazon, and in here I have the, I'm actually zoomed out as much as I can. I can't really zoom out anymore, but yeah, hope you can see these. So yeah, these are the 72 Artex pencils. I really, really like these Artex pencils. They're so soft and creamy to use, and lovely, lovely colours as well. So I really wanted to take them with me. So I've got 72 of those. And then we have 72, yeah, Arteezers as well, which sort of start over here, I think. So yep, Arteezers. I mean, the amount of pencils I'm taking, it's just, I know it's just a little bit crazy, but I like to have some of my favorite pencils with me so I can use them. So these are still the Arteezers, and then I included Arteezers again, and then these are the 36 Poscas, and they are so lovely to use. They're really nice to use. However, I do find that after about, say, three layers probably, they don't like to go on top of each other anymore. So yeah, I think they're a bit limited in terms of layering, but they are still lovely pencils and one of my favorites. And then I've got a 12 set. This was the very first Holbein set I got, which was the 12 pastel set. And then I also have got some of my brushes, miniature brushes, because I took a few paints. I always take a few metallic paints with me. So I've got a 50 Pro Art, which I got from Jackson's Art. Then this one is just a Sea White Cullinski Sable. cannot particularly remember where I got that one from. Just going to put it back in the plastic sleeve. Do you know, my hand can be so unsteady at times, but anyway. And then this one here is again the Pro Art, but it's a 2-0. And then I took with me some of these other brushes as well, which are sort of cheaper ones, just for applying glitter. So I've got a 5-0 one. These were just from Amazon. They still work quite well, so they're worth it. One size one, in fact, two size ones, but they look different. Anyway, those are the other pencil case that I took with me. And my mat is moving all over the place as well. And then, because of the book that I took with me, these, as if those weren't enough pencils, these pencils work really well. These are the Stadler Ergosoft. They work really, really well in it's this book that I took, because I've got a buddy colour in here with the lovely Wendy from Wendy at Happily Handmade. And we've got buddy colour in this book, and the Stadler Ergosoft worked quite well on the paper because the paper's quite smooth in the book. I like using these, and I like using my Polychromos, and I like using some other ones that I'll show you on that sort of paper. I have got the 36 set, but I obviously didn't take that with me. I just took the 24 because it comes in a nice little case. And then I took a small set. I mean, I didn't actually use these, but it's just a small little set. 15 Neo Colour 2s. I always take them with me just in case I want them for a background. And then in this pencil case, one of my favourite pencil cases, I took these metallic paints. In fact, I have a few that I was using yesterday, so I'll bring them out as well. So these were my choice to take on holiday. So I've got I've been sort of I'm in the process of swatching these, and I've decided to swatch them in a book, would you believe, because I was going to do it in a binder, but then I just felt like I wanted to do it in a book, because I think I saw Colouring F, I think that's Frances on YouTube, and she had all her metallic paints swatched in a book, and I thought they looked so neat and so nice. So I was just then, you know, inspired to do my swatches in a book as well, just for the metallic paints. So yeah, these are the Renaissance Colours Crown Jewels. Those are my favourites. Then these are the Art Spirits Rainbow Dust and Mirror Dust, which is two of my favourite glitter paints. So I was going to take them. Oh, not I was going to, I did. And then West End 1, these are again another one of my favourites. And then the Art Spirits Gold Set, because you always need golds, because they go with pretty much anything. And then this is my Scrim Ghost colours, which I bought quite a while ago from Scrim. Got all these bits coming off from somewhere, I don't know. So that's that. And then this one is again the Art Spirits, and we have True Silver, Gold Iridescence, gorgeous, gorgeous paints, Light Silver, Gold Dust, Disco Dusk and Glittering Luna. So stunning. And then these paints from Etch-A-Lab, which are the metallic set, which decided to just come out, as you can see. So these were sent to me to show on the channel. In fact, I chose to get these because they did ask me if I wanted to, what I'd like to show, and I picked these. These are amazing, amazing metallic watercolours. You can just see from the colours. I have got a video where I swatch these out and show you on camera. Absolutely love them. That's why they are one of my favourites. Therefore, I took them with me. So, yeah, those were everything that I put into this pencil case to take on holiday. And I'm just going to keep it like that now, because like I say, we are going to go away again, and I'll probably take all the same supplies, probably different books, but the same supplies. I mean, I took so many pencil cases, as you'll see. Then I took these two new water brushes, which I haven't even opened yet. And I haven't opened yet because I didn't actually use watercolour when I went away, but I just take it just in case. And then I took these, I think I've got 36 possibly, 36 Stadler fine liners, because I always need fine liners again for colouring in this book, Vertical Worlds. So yep, they were the fine liners, and then I just put the water brushes in there. And then in here, this pencil case, I have these pencils, which I really like using on the Vertical Worlds colouring book. These are the, what are they called? They're called the Lyra Groove Slim. So I did get these on Amazon. I guess you call them the groove, because they've got these grooves in the barrel. But they're lovely colours, and they are a harder pencil, but they are so pigmented. And I really like using these and the Staedtler Ergo Soft on the Vertical Worlds colouring book. And as I was taking that colouring book, I thought I would take these as well. And then I've just got some Prismacolors here that I was using, which I don't think I need to keep in there anymore, because I actually finished that page. What else did I take? So in my watermelon case, I took my, well, there's my close-up glasses. And then I took all these Pentel dual metallic hybrid pens, and in here also I have the Arteza iridescent glitter gel pens, which are always out of stock. And I don't understand why they're always out of stock. Surely they make more if they are really popular. So I'm hoping that they do make more of them, because they are probably the best, one of the best glitter gels I've tried. These are my top favourites, the Pentel Dual Metallic and the Arteza Iridescent Gel Pens. So if I had gel pen recommendation, it would be those two. So I took those with me. Did I use any? I don't even think I used them, but I just take them just in case. And then I've got some two longer brushes which didn't fit in the other pencil cases. That's a Princeton Round 3-0 and a Professional Watercolour Winsor Newton, I think it is, 0. And then these are my Jelly Roll glaze pens, and then there's these other glaze pens which aren't the Sakura ones, but there's some other ones that I found on Amazon, which work okay. They are a bit leaky, but they still work okay. So that's that one. And then two more pencil cases. So there's this one here, which has got some pastel gel pens. I think these are called the Pentel Hybrid Milky, and then these are the Signo Angelic Colour pastel gel pens. They're very nice to use. And then in here I have the, and I love these, I think these are one of the best metallics I've ever come across, the got a blender pencil which shouldn't be in there, but anyway, these are the I think got two silvers in here, one silver should be over there. Anyway, these are the silver Uniball Signo metallic pens, not silver, sorry, because that's just a color, right? And I think these are all the ones that they do. And then in the middle compartment here, I've got some Sakura Jelly Roll Moonlight Bright glaze pens. So that's that. And then finally, the last pencil case, which is this cute Pingu pencil case, is all my, you know, stuff that, you know, the essential stuff that you need, really. I'll just show you what I mean. So, just chucked it all out. Dump it all on the side there. So, white jelly roll highlights, of course. That's the Uniball Signo Broad. There's an Arteza one here. And then there's a Jelly Roll 08. I've never got any others, I don't know, I don't think so. I've got a Teagle, so you always need a spare sharpener. But the main sharpener that I do use is this M&R, probably the best handheld sharpener I've come across. Got a couple of Black Poskers. I've got my Tombow Mono Eraser and a spare because this one is nearly finished. What else? Another water brush, because why not? I have a Derwent blender pen and a Tombow blender brush. This is the finer blender pen. Just a normal black pen. A Bic intensity permanent marker, although there isn't anything really that I needed that for. And then a 02 Uniball and a Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pen fine liner. So these are the fine liner pens that I use for going over the lines in colouring books when metallic paint goes over them and sort of dulls them. I have a silver Uniball gel pen and a silver sparkling silver Uniball gel pen, because that's brilliant for adding glittery accents, and there's a gold version of that as well. And then I have this, which stickers come off, but anyway, this is a pipette for the paints, a pencil which I just got from the Royal Armouries in Leeds because we went on a little school visit, and then another Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pen fine liner there. And then here, this is a Jelly Roll clear clear glitter, a glaze. So these are like basically accent stuffs, a clear glaze, a black glaze, a little zebra pencil, a Caran d'Ache Caran d'Ache blender pencil, and one of my favourites is the Derwent blender pencil, a Derwent push button water brush, and a Staedtler eraser. So those were all my like essential bits, and I'm not going to put them away, and I'm just going to leave them here because I'm too lazy to take them out, put them back in, you know, when we're going to go on holiday again soon. Anyway, well, not soon, but near enough. So that's basically all the supplies. Just putting my close-up glasses away, if you're wondering what I'm doing. And yeah, the books I took with me, I took three books with me actually. I took the Mayan Riser Dirk Europa by Rita Berman, and then I took Illustrations by R.J. Hampson Dragon Dreams, and then the Vertical Worlds colouring book by Abby Dacre. Now, I really wanted to colour in the Dragon Dreams, but I just could not choose a page. I became so, indecisive. I just became so indecisive. I could not decide on a page. I really wanted to do this one, and then I thought, no, and then I wanted to do this one, and then I just kept changing my mind all the time, so I put that to one side, and I have finished the page in here, and it is a long way to the August completed pages, so I'm going to show you a quick little peek. So this is, I didn't finish it on holiday, I sort of half did it, yeah, I had three quarters done on holiday, but yeah, that's the page I've done. I've messed up the circle bit here, but anyway, I'm not going to go on about it too much because it is for my August completed pages. And then I did start, look how mucky this book is getting here, I did start the body colour, and I have been working on it since I got home, so I didn't do this much, but I'll just show you. I did print this one off, which I found on Pinterest, and I think this was the picture coloured by. And the only reason I printed this out, and this was when I came back home after my holiday, was because I just used to get I got confused with the lines, and I want you know for this roller coaster, and I wanted to know. This was just made it a bit clearer on how to do it, so that's why I printed that out. But mine is this. Now, I didn't get all of this done on holiday. I think I only got done about that much. So I got all of this top bit done, I think. So I have been working on it, but it is taking me ages. So that was a quick peek at the two pages that I've been working on. Well, one is complete anyway. And that's it really. That's the stuff I took on holiday, my colouring stuff. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this short little video, and until next time, take care, happy colouring, bye.